Okay. We're back to Star Wars Squadrons. I was playing Mission 7 and something, it told me to look at like my loadout, and when I did that, it like glitched. So I'm gonna do this again here. Let's talk to Friskin Gunny.
All I'm saying is, instead of blowing up that listening post, we should have commandeered it. Imagine the kind of fun we could have had messing with the Imperials, or the credits we could make.
As your squad leader, I'm gonna pretend I didn't just hear that.
Come on, Gunny. You telling me the New Republic couldn't use more intel? And you know war ain't cheap.
Actually, that's a good point. I guess once you steal a Star Destroyer, everything Imperial starts to look tempting.
You know, we used to be rebels. We turn into a legit republic, and suddenly we all gotta stay on the straight and narrow.
The commander's lining up a trap for Teresa Carroll. That's not enough of a con for you?
In the old days, I'd trick her for everything but a pair of boots to stand in. But I guess this'll do.
Well, when he's right, he's right. Now, how about we get some actual work done?
All right, let's get a briefing.
First, congratulations. Because you captured the Star Destroyer Victorum, our Starhawk prototype has been completed ahead of schedule. But the Empire does not know that. They believe it's still under construction. Teresa Carroll will keep hunting Project Starhawk until it's destroyed, and we've been assigned to stop her. So, using that decoy message I sent, we're going to set up an ambush. The false intel stated that you're protecting a shipment of magnite crystals essential to completing the Starhawk. With this bait, we'll draw Teresa and the Overseer deep into the Xavian Abyss, a highly volatile area of space. Here is where we set our trap. Don't worry about the convoy. It's empty and droid piloted. However, that does mean you'll need to clear any obstructions from its path. Vanguard, I want you to defend that convoy with everything you've got. We need to make this look good. Your destination is this bottleneck. There, the Starhawk will be waiting to disable the Overseer, and hopefully, capture Teresa. Now, it might sound simple, but nothing is simple in the Xavian Abyss. Brace yourselves.
Alright, stuck to Arda.
If Linden's right, this plan could knock Teresa Carroll off our tail. Sooner the better, if you ask me. Linden's convinced himself that he's put us in danger. I can't make him focus on the bigger picture while Teresa's still in it. The commander's a smart man, but everyone has someone who can push their buttons. I wonder if we can push hers, too. We'll give Teresa a harmless convoy to follow, play this out, and see just how far we can lead her. It's all about playing the long game. When the Empire occupied Mon Cala, I learned how to string Imperials along. If you seem harmless, people underestimate you. I spent a lot of time around Imperials, playing the dumb alien. Bartender, a sweeper, someone safe. Next day, the rebellion would know everything I'd overheard. It wasn't easy, but I learned to stay patient and wait for opportunities. Remember, the Xavian Abyss is no place for the faint-hearted. And Teresa knows a few tricks of her own. Keep your eyes and ears open, all right?
And Linden Jeeves.
And the Starhawk's crew.
More than ready. I selected the crew personally based on their expertise and experience. They've been training for months.
That's good. I appreciate your support on this, General.
It's a good plan, Linden. Just be careful. I know you have a past with the Overseer's captain. Don't let it cloud your judgment.
One moment, General. Sorry. I can't talk right now. Your squadron is waiting.
Okay. Back to the hangar. Let's talk to Frisk.
So, the boss wants to pull the old bait and switch on Teresa. I must be rubbing off on him. Of course, the key to a good con is selling it. And going into the Xavian Abyss, well, either you're too naive to know better, or you think it's worth the risk. Like, say, stopping a Starhawk from being finished. Teresa Carroll's risking the Abyss just for the chance to destroy some Magnite crystals. Ain't she in for a surprise? I'm kind of excited to see our Starhawk tackle Teresa's flagship. All those engineers worked their tails off to get it finished. That's one good thing about this new Republic. We're finally punching at the same weight as the Empire. One way or another, this is gonna be a show.
Alright, and then Grace, then we'll head out.
I've heard tales of the Xavian Abyss. They say it's swallowed entire fleets without a trace. Sending our brand new Starhawk in there is quite the gamble. Commander Jade must have complete faith in its builders. And in us, of course. We'll be the ones making this ruse work, after all. I took the liberty of studying the Starhawk's blueprints. It's not just another capital ship. It's a defense against Imperial fleets. Every spare inch is packed with lasers and munitions, but what really caught my eye was the tractor beam. If I understood the blueprints, the Starhawk's tractor beam is 10 times more powerful than that of a Star Destroyer. It's incredible. The Magnite crystals they use in the Starhawk's tractor beam are quite rare. I think they salvaged a few from the Star Destroyer we captured. My family spent an exorbitant amount of credits sourcing Magnite crystals. It's so gratifying to see them go to a good cause. Let's put our new Starhawk through its paces, shall we?
Alright.
You got your choice of fighters for this mission. An X-Wing, Y-Wing, or A-Wing. They've all got pros and cons. Check the schematics and let me know what'll suit you.
I'm gonna stick with this, but I'm gonna edit it. I liked the strong shooting. Let's see, so we already have that automatically fires at your attackers when activated, stripping their shields and disabling them. Ideal for getting attackers off your back. Can fire missiles at multiple targets simultaneously. Ideal against groups and turrets. Receives significantly less damage from front. Deals very high damage from long range, but has a long lock. We'll stick with those. Countermeasures. Measures. Drops a cloud behind you that breaks and locks and stops missiles and mines. Fires multiple projectiles behind you that intercept missiles locked onto you. We'll stick with the cloud. The hull. I think this one I like. Although I like maneuverability and acceleration, I do like way more health. I think this is the one. This one. Hostile lock time. Yeah, I prefer health shields. When shields reach you, the Starfire takes much less damage from lasers. Reduces. It will keep the shield and engine. Alright, here we go. Back at select time, I won't make the mistake of holding. That's some reason when I hold the select button, it like takes me to Steam, but this game's not being run through Steam. It's being run since it's just doing toggled in VR. It's not being run through Steam, but it, like, Steam still pops up and kind of glitches.
As you can see,
yes, if I. I have to hold it in, but Steam wants to go to like its menu when I do that. Rotary cannon. Alright.
Her flagship overseer is closing in. Good luck, Vanguard. Protect that convoy. And see you on the other side.
You can feel it, right? Chaos on every side. We don't belong here.
It ain't need to see what does.
Hey, what happens once the Starhawk disables the Overseer?
The same as the Victorum, I expect. Board it, lock its systems, and take the crew prisoner.
I don't know, Grace. I can't imagine Teresa Carroll coming along quietly. I hate these clouds. Who knows what's out there?
We know what's out there. A Star Destroyer with a captain who wants us dead.
Real helpful. Thanks, Gunny. The convoy's droid autopilot ain't smart enough to steer through these asteroids.
Then let's blast them a path.
Ships are on radar.
Scouts. Perfect. The boss's plan is working. Give them a show. Make sure they buy it.
I wasn't worried.
Got one!
Alright, where are these guys? Some of these other. Oh, wrong button. Crap. Alright, let's see.
I caught those ties scanning the convoy. Do you think they know there's no magnite?
You're in the clear.
Enemy is destroyed.
Taking out these guys pretty easily.
Yes.
Is this guy like flying around me? Where are they? They're like right now. See the last one? Got a bit close there. Let's get out of this. There we go. There should only be one more. Where's this last one? Yeah.
Let's keep going.
I repeat, Vanguard, the Imperials scanned the convoy, but the Overseer is still on approach. They must have stopped the ties before they could transmit that scan. Vanguard.
Signal's breaking up. Let's push on.
The ambush point is this way. Ready? Let's go.
To the main objective. I assume at least that big ship, this destroyer, I think. Oh, there it is.
There it is. The Overseer.
Or Overseer, not destroyer.
Finally. We've drawn it in.
Nobody panic. This is the plan. Defend the convoy and keep luring the Overseer to the ambush point.
I'm getting lit up already.
Challenge an Imperial Star Destroyer. The Overseer's closing in. Clear those asteroids before we lose the convoy. Guess Teresa decided to handle this convoy herself.
Let's get out of here. Oh, crap. Dang it. Ah, I died.
It is. The Overseer.
I don't think I was supposed to really attack that.
Nobody panic. This is the plan. Defend the convoy and keep luring the Overseer to the ambush point. How could you challenge an Imperial Star Destroyer? We gotta clear out the asteroids. The Overseer's gonna take out the convoy.
Yeah, definitely was doing the wrong thing. I should have went here.
I got the cold sweat on my neck.
Stay focused.
I am. I'm very focused on the Star Destroyer right behind me.
Trapped. With nowhere to go.
Launch fighters!
More Imperial fighters! Check behind! Focus on the bombers!
There we go. Crap, what the heck? Oh man, I am just having bad luck on this mission.
More Imperial fighters, check behind.
There's dudes like way outside the map. I wonder why.
That's just rude.
Yeah, I wonder what the heck was going on there.
range. Try to focus on the ties. The Starhawk will handle the Overseer. If we can make it to the bottleneck in time, we will. We just have to push forward.
There. That's the bottleneck the boss mentioned. Lyndon James to Vanguard. We have you on radar. Keep going. You're almost in range.
What's going on there? I don't know what's going on. Jeez. Man, that thing is brutal. Stuck on.
I got you. Reloading. Fine. You're off course. Watch the storm. I'll leave a mark. Capture beam is charging. 34%.
So we just have the last. I see. Jeez, this is tough. Alright, so we just gotta last. Survive. Whatever this tractor beam keeps getting me. Can I not destroy that thing? Dang, I guess I can't destroy those guns. Just focus on these guys, I guess.
You're almost in range.
Taking out our fighters one by one should be very distracting. Captain Carroll's Vanguard Squadron, this is a futile gesture. You have nowhere to go, and I have no interest in prisoners.
The drive.
this guy.
Enemy is persistent. Enemy locked on.
What's wrong, Teresa? Can't hit something that ain't a helpless convoy.
Catch beams at 61%.
Let's get out of here. What? Did I get like on the wrong side? I was like doing really good there.
Starhawk works.
Toss the Overseer around like a low threat.
Good. Lousy Imperials deserve payback with interest.
Shall we just build a Death Star and get it over with?
Oh, come on, Grace. We're still the good guys. Anyhow, we won, right? Wherever they jumped, no ship's coming back from that.
Let's hope so.
Yeah, did, oh, I still got three, surprisingly. What? I got the efficiency medal? That's kind of surprising. Yeah, without dying, that shot down three missiles fired by the Overseer. I didn't shoot them down, but I used my that cloud thing, so. But I'm surprised I got three. I thought I was going to get like one or two. That's kind of surprising. Alright, well, thanks again for watching. I'm going to try to upload each week. I'm going to do like two missions at a time, but upload at least one each week. But yeah, thanks for watching, and we'll keep doing this until we're done. I think we're past halfway now, or a little bit past, but thanks again. Thank you.